Hello, my name is Dr. Bob DiMaria, the drugless doctor, and what I want to talk to you about today is breast cancer. You know, there have been some famous celebrities in the news recently that have made some decisions that have impacted their health, but I know that it impacts many of your health also because, you know, you trust what you see on television and what some of these celebrities are doing. But I want you to know two thoughts right now. Men can get breast cancer. Over 2,000 men, it is estimated, get breast cancer every year, and a couple hundred of them die. And that's not fun. But what I want to talk to you ladies about today, if you have made the decision to have some genetic testing and you happen to have a positive BRCA1 and BRCA2, what do you do? Because it seems like the option so far has been to have a breast removal. And let's just say that you don't have those genetic background tendencies. What do you do? Well, I'm going to give you what I have learned, and I've been really blessed. I've written several books, and Dr. Bob's Drugless Guide to Balancing Female Hormones is a tremendous book that will help give you the insight of exactly what you need to do. 95% of all breast cancer is caused by too much estrogen. And the too much estrogen comes from various places. But your liver has to process the estrogen. That is really important, ladies and gentlemen. Tender breasts and heavy menstrual flow are body signals of too much estrogen. Varicose veins, spider veins, and hemorrhoids are a body signal of a plugged up or compromised liver. You want your liver functioning optimally. If you have a heavy menses, you want to make sure that your liver is functioning optimally to process the estrogen. That is very, very significant. Now, over time, I'm going to share some things that you can do that'll give you peace of mind. And I've done a lot of research on this, and I have literally helped thousands of ladies go through this journey of optimal hormonal health. Iodine. There's a term that I want you to write down right now called apoptosis. Apoptosis is limited cell life. Iodine helps limit cell life of unwanted cancer cells. There is a urine iodine loading test that you can do to determine if you have enough iodine. Unfortunately, bromine, fluorine, and chlorine, that's bromine, fluorine, and chlorine, take iodine out of the body. So I mentioned to you, compromised liver, bromine, fluorine, and chlorine take iodine out of the body. The third item I want to share with you, also apoptosis, is vitamin D. Most people that I see that come into our practice don't have enough vitamin D. You can have your vitamin D3 tested. It should be 40. People with dark skin tend not to have enough vitamin D. Other individuals who are not in the sun don't have enough vitamin D also. I take 6,000 units of vitamin D every day. I take 12 milligrams of iodine every day. Ladies, you can have your urine estrogen tested. There's a number 2 and a number 16 estrogen urine. Number 2 is good. Number 16 is not as good. So I'm going to repeat and give you some drugless tips, applications for preventing and monitoring breast cancer. Number 1, you want to make sure your liver is functioning optimally. If you have varicose veins, spider veins, or hemorrhoids, and or cherry hemangiomas, work on liver cleansing. Watch some of my segments on the liver itself. Have your iodine level checked. Urine iodine loading. You want to have a 95% with that. You want to check your vitamin D. Vitamin D should be at least 40. That's vitamin D3. And finally, have your urine estrogen number 2 and 16 checked. If those are within the normal, you're all set. If your 16's a little bit higher, start eating broccoli. Broccoli and cruciferous vegetables will help lower that. My passion, ladies, is to save your breasts and to save your ovaries. My name is Dr. Bob DiMaria, and I am the Drugless Doctor.